Speaking of novels, here are the 3x5, or what, here are the index cards I've started to put my ideas on. Right now, my brain's not quite sharp enough to really do any real writing, or even editing, but I've started letting these ferment for when I'm feeling better. Well, that's going to be reversed for you to see. The deal is one day, one project. The objective is to finish and make ready for sharing and publication while avoiding detours, unuseful digressions, or starting completely new projects. Result? Less raw, more ready, and good feeling in my heart. The first one is the story of Palau. And this you've seen up on the board with the, on my wall with a collage, but this is maybe my finest, most fulfilling adventure, where I went to the small island of Peleliu, Palau, on the edge of nowhere, after hopscotching my way around on ferries and boats and float planes and going completely rogue, I guess. The next one is the Belize story. This one you probably know is when I had sold one of my internet companies in 2000. The acquiring company turned out to be evil. They seemed nice before the paper was signed, but they wanted me to take a drug test. Called me in the office. VP, HR flew up from California, and we heard you were smoking marijuana at the company golf tournament. Well, no shit, right? But I lawyered up and fought back and split town to let the process go, and I went to an island called Key Cocker that had just had a big hurricane, and I found a little cabin to rent for $8 a night, and I just sort of hunkered down and went local for a couple weeks. I had a broken wrist at the time, too. What's up with me and hospital visits? The next one, I did a dictation of this, but I'm not sure how, I haven't read it back, but this was me and my buddy Marty Kendall going down a canyon in southern Utah and getting caught in a flash flood and having to jump off this waterfall, and there's straight canyon walls up other side, and it was hardcore. And then we finally got, you had to throw our packs down and then dive down and grab them, haul them up, and it's, and then took a bunch of pain pills and fell asleep by the fire and awoke with my clothes on fire. The next morning our boots were melted and we still had a two-day hike that we did in one day, marching out of there. And then we had no car at the end. We had to hitchhike, and we were, like, tore up vagabonds. It's ended up in a little town and camped in behind, like, some tasty freeze in some town there. Next one is the story of Yap. Yap is an island near Palau, relatively speaking, where they use giant stone money. The women are bare-breasted. All the land is run by tribal chiefs, and I had a real powerful experience there because, and I started to dictate this one, so we'll see if it gives me some framework. Because I speak Japanese, I could speak with the old-timers rather than having to have a middle ground with the young folks. Next one is the story of Taos, New Mexico, which is, I was on a lost summer when I was 21, cruising around my Volkswagen bus all around Western United States, and me and this crazy Pakistani guy I was traveling with, we inadvertently were camped out on an Indian reservation, and two dudes hopped in the back, pulled a gun, and we had to drive through the forest in the desert and end up at their house, and they got a big automatic rifles and then trout and rabbit stew and shot at us. It was a very strange night. The social media kung fu, which you're well familiar with. I've been compiling the notes that folks took from the day-long session. I have the audio from that. I haven't listened back to it at all. Fuck Stats Make Art is dying to be made into a book. I have all the art and I have all the dialogue. Another cousin of that is Art and Tech, our old pals. The Are You Worthy? Greeks to Geeks. You've probably seen this. There's two different talks. I'm going to kind of combine them and make another creativity type thing. Some framing and picture projects. Let's see. It's a little to-do list. Boxes from liquor store. Did that today. Start with the studio, use what can be used, consolidate and reduce. Give away stuff, garage sale, hire truck. I'm gonna get rid of a whole bunch of my books and put a little paper inside of them. Liberated Literature is the name of this project, where people can then put their name. It's basically read it, sign it, share it. You write your name, maybe some comments, where you found it or something, and then you just hand it off to someone else. Maybe there will be a hashtag, and you can track these books going around the world. It's about organizing my studio and using my binders, art supplies, and kits. I've got some binders out here. I'm sorting through. See, I've kind of kept every little paper about myself, newspaper clippings, report cards, and everything ever since I was a kid. It's kind of manic, but it'll make a great documentary one day. And I have these variety of these poetry chat books. I've sort of done some rough versions of to share with friends. Depth Perception is one, and then some haikus, and just little, and those deserve to be finished and put out there. This is more about self-publication and writerly and all that stuff and learning about that. Something about exercise. Let's see. Lounging on beach. Haven't done that. Going to the pool. No. Walking every once in a while. Anyway, that's what I'm working on. I also just glued the hand back onto this statue. I've been hauling this guy around since Hawaii when I was 13 or 14 and his hand had fallen off, but I found the right kind of glue. And today was the day his hand was fixed. I think it's symbolic somehow. And also I found this belt buckle from when I was 11 years old going to scout camp. And this medallion in the middle is two-sided, and I probably in my youth couldn't decide which side to put forward. But now I've just glued that down, so I got a cool little belt buckle. Now I need a belt to put it on. Inside of my binders I also have all my ribbons from winning the school science fair a bunch of times too. It's that kind of stuff. So first I'm going to meditate a little bit. And then keep futzing along with my projects.